Welcome back to our week two of our music class, our distance learning music class, everyone. Thank you to those people who were able to respond to the seesaw activity last week and introduce yourself a little bit. For those of you that I've seen before, it helps me to remember your names and see your faces again and learn a little bit about you. And for those of you who I haven't met yet, who are new to university, then I get to meet you through that way as well. So thank you. All right, so we are going to start today with some rhythms. So it's going to be Mr. Cervenka's turn first, and I'm gonna say it and use this little laser pointer, and then it will be your turn after that. Ready? Do, do day, do. Now it's your turn. Ready? And say it, go. Oh, thanks. Sorry about that in between. One more time, but this time, could you say do and clap while you say it? Ready, go. Do. Good. And for this one, we're going to have, it has two sounds, so we're going to say do day. You try it. Ready, go. Thanks. One more time from the beginning. I'm going to clap and say it, so I'm not going to use the laser pointer this time. Ready? Do. Do day, do. Notice that when we get to this one, this is called a rest, a quarter rest. That means we're silent for one beat. All right, here's our next rhythm. Watch and listen this time. Do day, do day, do. Your turn, and see if you can get those claps in it. When we get to this one, it's gonna sound like this. Do. So we clap on one side, and we move it across straight. Ready, your turn, here we go. Do day, do day, do. Good. Next one, my turn first, and then your turn. Do day, do, do. Your turn, ready, go. Thank you. Last one. Do, do day, do. Your turn, ready, go. All right. So, We're seeing some of those notes again. Now, if you've never seen these notes before, that's okay. We're going to review them. But for right now, I just want you to see them, see if anything comes back into your brain. You, if you have gone to other schools before, might even know these with a different language. And that's okay, because there's different rhythm languages that different musicians use sometimes. So, all right, we are going to move a little bit. So when we hear the music start, you are going to dance with your fingers only to start. This is going to be the dance of the fingers. Ready? Ooh, how was that? Now, this time, it's going to be the dance of the wrists. Just your wrists. Got it? You can only move your wrists. Ooh. Now, let's see. This time it's going to be the dance of your arms. You get to move all of your arms, but not anything else in your body. Are you ready? Might need a little bit more space. What else could we dance with? Could you dance with only your feet? Just your feet, nothing else. Not your whole legs, just your feet. Here we go with the dance of the feet. Maybe you're tapping your toes, moving them side to side. How about your shoulders? Just your shoulders. Just move your shoulders this time. Could you think of a part of your body that you could dance with? Maybe it will be your stomach or your nose or your chin or your whole legs, whatever it is, you pick a part of your body that you are going to dance with. Here he comes. And now it's the dance of your whole body. You get to move and dance with your whole body. Ready, go. All right, thanks for dancing. Never knew we could dance online like that. How about that? All right, moving on. We are going to use our singing voice, and you can see some shapes and some lines on our screen. So, I'm going to go just like before. It'll be Mr. Cervenka's turn first, and then you do it with your singing voice at home. Now, our singing voice doesn't sound like our speaking voice, right? I'm talking to you with my speaking voice right now, but our singing voice is going to sound a little higher and a little lighter than our speaking voice. Okay, here we go. Ready? Woo! Your turn. Ready, go. Nice job. Ooh, this one's going to sound a little different like this. Ooh. You try it. Ready, go. Nice job. How about this one? All right, your turn. Ready, go. And one more. Your turn. Nice job, Aces. Good work. All right. And today we are going to learn a rhyme that goes at a certain rhythm. It's called Chip Chop. So this time, all you're going to do is you're going to listen. Listen with your ears and see if you can listen with even more than your ears. Maybe your whole body can listen. Ready? Goes like this. Chip, chop, chippity chop. Cut off the bottom and cut off the top. What you have left, put in the pot. Chip, chop, chippity chop. Okay. Now I'm going to add something. This time, listen again and watch what I do, okay? I'm going to put my one arm out, and I'm going to kind of do some tapping and stuff. Ready? Watch what I do. Chip, chop, chippity chop. Cut off the bottom and cut off the top. What you have left, put in the pot. Chip, chop, chippity chop. See if I can get centered here a little bit better. Okay, now if you think, I know you couldn't see everything that time. You can either watch again and listen and maybe join me with some of the words, or you can join me with some of the actions that you saw, or you can just listen. It's up to you. Ready? Chip, chop, chippity chop. Cut off the bottom and cut off the top. What you have left, put in the pot. Chip, chop, chippity chop. Thanks. I'm going to do one part. You do one part after me. So I'll let you, there will be some space for you to repeat it after me. Ready? Chip, chop, chippity chop. Your turn. Ready and go. Cut off the bottom and cut off the top. What you have left, put in the pot. Chip, chop, chippity chop. All right, let's see if I can put two parts together. And then it'll be your turn to do two parts. Ready? Chip, chop, chippity chop. Cut off the bottom and cut off the top. Your turn. Ready and go. Last two parts. What you have left, put in the pot. Chip, chop, chippity chop. What do you think this rhyme is about? What are we chopping up? And then we're taking it all and we're putting it in a pot. What could it be? Got some pictures here. Could be some carrots, maybe some other vegetables. What do you think? Could we maybe chop up some potatoes and put them in a pot? Or could we chop up some onions and put them in a pot maybe? What would we be making if we were chopping these vegetables and other foods up and putting them in a pot? Could we be making some soup or some stew, something yummy to eat, right? So this rhyme could be about cooking, chopping up some vegetables and putting them in a pot and mixing them together to make something yummy. Here's the whole thing. You can say it with me if you feel you're ready and do the motions, or you can listen again and then pause it after and then try it on your own after when it's paused. Ready? Here's the whole thing. Chip, chop, chippity chop. Cut off the bottom and cut off the top. What you have left, put in the pot. Chip, chop, chippity chop. All right, thanks. University Avenue Aces. That is the end of our lesson for today. Please go over to Seesaw. There will be another short activity and the instructions will be there for you. And that's it for today. Thank you so much. We will see you again next week. Bye.